All right, then we got a holy paladin in here. I don't know what you're saying, Dalaran. Did you lose your mind? You put a holy paladin in here. Look, you said Shocketon might be a thing. So the chat will decide. Do they want to see more Shocketon or not? But that's going to be Cinnamon. We got Avenger. We got Itachi, my man. Shadow Priest, Kasha, QD, and Reza. These guys are still trying to figure out who's going to be going first or last. What do we got on Team Other? What do we got on Team Honor? We got Fast Skills from Ragnaros. We got Grizzle. We got Curson. How you doing? My guy Love and On EU going up first. Try to wait out to see who's going to be up. Now, I know that going against the Holy Paladin might be boring. He just might be literally healing all day. He said he's playing Shocking and we'll give it a go. It might be the best thing you've ever seen and the closest duels are the most fun thing. It might not be. And I know it could be either way. It could swing in any direction. But we're just going to roll with it, see how it goes, boys. It's going to be off the bat, Kasha QD versus Aniu, DH versus Pala. Gotta just look at each other. I mean, they can start at any moment right now. Aniu is going to get the resources going, mounting up, going to have a bunch of fewer to work with Kasha. Playing a retribution Pala, it's going to be a Demon Hunter, one of the most mobile classes in the game with plenty of weird utility abilities. And Kasha QT. Just big old damage from a big old red. Wings coming down. Gonna be a chicken out of Aniu. Waiting for the wings in order to try to see if he can get away from Kasha. Actually, Kasha's taking quite a bit of damage. And hasn't even been doing that much. Isn't having him been hit by Aniu that much. Gonna be going up in the air to try to see if he can break through the Chill of Vengeance. As Kasha's just gonna heal up as much as he can. Throwing a couple of judgments and they're not gonna be able to get the Chill of Vengeance to pop back Aniu. But this is where Kasha sells his wings. So he got plenty of damage rolling with. Needs to get a couple of Chumper's Verdicts in there. Gonna be a Malak dropping down Aniu. Does get a short stun. Aniu Kasha does force out a chicken. And Aniu is gonna get hit with a Malak right now to follow. No, or maybe not. What? Now he's gonna get. What? Okay. What was that run? What was that run just now? I'm just so confused. I can't even tell who's throwing Maddox anyway. But that's gonna be bubble out of Kasha. Hodge coming on Aniu. And down it goes, getting obliterated by a red paladin. Just like that. That was a rough one to start with, man. Rough one for a Pala and DH. Because DH is. The problem with DH. Wait, what's up next? Is it Curson? F3. There we go. Now it works. Okay, for some reason F3 just took me to a whole other person. But with the DH, it's just like a lot of like a rogue, like a feral, like a monk. If you get stun locked, you have nothing. You're just dying stuns. That's the life of leather classes. But Curson is trying to see if he can make it work. He's gonna go for a big vendetta on Takasha right now. Might be a bop on Takasha. Could bop it early. Is gonna bop it early to get rid of the damage. Gonna be a blood elf racial for Curson off the bat. Is gonna be belfing off the bop and tried to go for a kick. Did he land one on Kasha though? That's going to be Malik onto a red pally. Satan Chicken does get procced out of Curson as all his defenses are getting procced so fast. Doesn't have a trinket, so Kasha could literally obliterate him in a single hodge. Barely is the nail. Is Kasha going to be in a good position? Or Curson going to be in a good position? He's going to go for that evasion a little bit early, but that hodge is still going to clap you out right now. Another kid onto Kasha might want to disengage as red pally could have a lot of damage still ready. Is actually playing very defensively, just trying to get mobile. It's going to get a slow on the rogue. Flash of Light does come out. Curson does get a vanish in. Shortest cheap shot ever. Does Kasha have a hodge, because this could be the end of it. Wings are coming out. It's going to get a big crit onto Curson, but Curson actually does snag the kill. Chidea saving him by a hair. That's going to be Touch. Trying to see if he can just score a kill right then and there onto Curson. Did get himself. I think he tried to go for a death, Shadow Ward death in there. But it's going to be a Cloak of Shadows out of Curson immediately. Itachi is going to snag the ice. Does poke the rogue out for just a second. Is going to land into a fear. Curson has nothing left for this. Going to get the Mindbender on them. He's going to get a bit of damage onto Curson. That's going to be a bit of shadow damage with a Void Eruption to finish off. Does he have the Execute to work with? Should have it. And down he goes. Itachi is going to go clap himself a couple of Shadow Mans. The next is going to be Love. That's going to be another rogue off the bat. Is that another Sass? I think it is going to be Sub. I want to say it's Sub, because I'm seeing that smoke bomb on the side. Normally, we wouldn't be seeing that smoke bomb poking out from the right side of On EU, unless it was a sub rogue with cold blood. We'll see how it's going to go, though. Karatachi is going to get himself shields up a little bit early. It's going to get a dot, and it's going to try to see if he can just get a... Ooh, not going to let Love get an opener at all. It's just going to stun lock him, get the dots rolling. Blind coming out immediately onto Itachi. Love is trying to see if he can force out maybe a trick out of Itachi. Not going to happen. Love is still going to be able to snag that opener that he needs. So he's still going to be able to get quite a bit of damage, though. Unless this man is lagging a little bit too much. Let's hope he isn't. He's gonna get that Nightblade in. The Shadow Strikes does come out into a dance. Cheap Shot does get the Nightblade again. Gonna be tricking Fear before Itachi. It's gonna be Love actually using his trinket, not the racial, to break out of the fear. Might have been a bold move here, and I don't think it's gonna pay off, but it looks like Itachi just as a priest just takes way too much damage compared to a rogue. He's gonna have to bail out of there. But he said, you know what? Out of that disperse, I'm gonna get back in this rogue. I'm gonna get in there ASAP. Dropping down the Siphene, and that's going to be a Cloak of Shadows out of Love. Not going to have a trinket, but it's still going to have the Rachel. The Forsaken Rogue Rachel. Should have it actually up right now if he needs it for the next fear. Not going to have it for the stun, though. Might have it for the mind control, so I could be wrong on that one, though. So at least, it's probably not a good idea to trinket. Probably you want to use Rachel early, because you can use trinket for a variety of things. But that fear could literally put him in a bad spot right now. Itachi's not going to have CC for quite a bit of time, though. It's going to get the Greater Fade. Trying not to get kicked by Love right now. It's going to go for that stun into a VT and into a Mind Bender. Love, it needs to get some big damage. Actually going to go under the bridge right now. Trying to LOS the Shadow Priest. Trying to see if he can get away. It's going to be Mind Bender. Vantage coming out for Love. Going to be burning a lot of defenses. But he did get another defensive out of Itachi. That is going to be of Empyrean Breaks. That's going to be a huge defensive. It looks like Itachi still has dots on Love. He's still going to be able to hit him with a Mind Play. And Love decided, you know what? I'm going to get in the Kidney Shot coming down. That's going to be shielded a little bit early for Itachi. But Love still got plenty of damage. That's going to be big Chris, big in Venom. Or big Eviscerate. I'm sure you saw Assassin's Rogues. Fear coming in. Is not going to use the racial for it, though. Should have it up and running. Didn't have the racial. Is going to go for a bit of a... I don't know what the hell that was. I hope that was not... Pretty sure it wasn't a racial. I'm pretty sure it was detect, stealth, or something. Or self-detection. Or heightened senses. Heightened awareness? I don't know. I think it's a... It's a glyph for rogues. I forget. Yeah, it is. He's just spamming it at this point. He's just spamming it. Just spamming it. Get a shot onto Itachi right now. This is where Love can get for some big damage. Is he gonna go for big damage? Actually, no Shadow Blades, no, but he's not getting those big eviscerates in there. Slowed onto Love. He's gonna have a trick in very, very soon. And this is where Itachi's gonna have to play defensively a little bit. Siphon onto Love. It's gonna slow him down. He's getting some damage on him. Actually, able to get quite a bit of damage into Love right now. He's gonna get a concoction to fight through the dots. 12% dampening. And Itachi is gonna get himself a lot of healing. As long as Love has dots on him, as long as those dots do proc as well as they are. It's taking quite a bit of damage. He can't really recover. So Itachi, all he needs to do is maintain those dots on him the whole time. Let's get the Mind Flay a little bit just to slow Love down. He has to make sure that VT and the Pain are there at all times. As long as he can do that, he'll be fine. Cloaking Shot is coming out. It's going to be Love cloaking through the matting into a Kidney Shot onto Itachi right now. Trying to see if he can burn the big damage into him. Fear immediately. Should have Rachel. No, going to trinket out of it. It's a stun. Why is it not Rachel at all as an undead? Now he's just left cowering with a Mind Bender. Just nipping away at him. Love, it just leaves. He just quits. I think the man was lagging the whole time. But that is going to be a rage quit out of the rogue. Itachi getting that kind of a reaction out of rogues is interesting. Sorry, boys. I had a little bit of a cough. I'm yelling into the mic. Are you going to drink sometime here? It's going to be Itachi getting that Greater Fade, but it's going to be interrupted by Grizzle. That's going to be a whole nother beast right here. Instead of a rogue, it's going to be a massive feral. Walk him out for Grizzle a little bit early. That's going to be Itachi cycling through Vampiric Embrace. It's not going to go for the Disperse a little bit early. Trying to get some resources onto Grizzle. Does still have Void Vorm for a little bit longer. As long as he gets those instant casts immediately back to back, he should be able to get the most value on the damage. It looks like the damage is actually starting to ramp up, and Grizzle sees this ramp up. Going to go for Incarn right now and cycle through the comp point so fast, getting so many finishes back to back. He's just maintaining himself just with that alone. One wall. Second wall actually got used already. Itachi at very low health is going to have to go for the Disperse. Still able to get quite a bit of healing. But Grizzle does get a couple different finishes in there, so he's still able to get a regrowth off that. So for Itachi, this is actually going to be really rough. Grizzle doesn't have a trinket, so Itachi does have that CC chain that he can follow up. With a fear and a stun and everything. Maybe with a mind control if he needs it. Going to be great to fade. Try to see if he can get a kick out of Grizzle. Not going to happen. Going to go for damage right after. Does he have any damage to follow? Grizzle just maintained himself. That's going to be Siphon. Does he kill it though? Siphon is actually going to block a lot of that healing. Grizzle needs to kill it ASAP. But Itachi barely has any health. He's just going to go. He is just going to go for a big old bite just to finish him off. Next up is going to be Reza. Razor just doesn't want to let the Feral get a restyle. Just wants to get the dot in there. Death and Decay knocking him out. Might even go for a grip. Does let a grip. War Stomp for Grizzle. Didn't even waste any time. Just knew he needed to War Stomp immediately. Fast reaction out of a Feral. And this is where Razor is just going to try to see if he can catch up. Looking like he wants to leverage the thorns in order to get some damage into Razor. He is getting quite a bit of chunk. Where Grizzle needs to be aware of his own health. Sun coming down. That could be a lot of necrotics getting stacked up. Sadly, safety trick just procking for him. 28% damage, reducing the value of that shield. But it still does get it. That's going to be a lot of necrotics in Grizzle. And Razor does have some dots rolling. But he can just kind of still chug the damage along at Grizzle. Not letting him get any kind of reheals. Malada coming out onto Grizzle. Locked out completely. He needs to use mobility to get away. Does get a bash on Razor. He's going to be IBF force out. Trying to go for a last ditch. Regrowth not gonna happen, and down he goes. Next up is gonna be fast kills. Fast skills, not fast kills. Fast skills, a blood oath. Blade assassination versus Razor. It's gonna go from a sap into a full kid shot on Razor. No, it's gonna be DR'd actually. And Razor is gonna go for the chance fusion, healing ASAP. Fast skills does have a mean vendetta rolling on the Death Knight. But Razor looks like he's just gonna maintain himself the whole time. That's gonna be a stun of fast skills right now. Is gonna force a trinket out of him. And fast. Is it going to pop more defensive? That's going to be A-Bomb joining the fight. And that's going to be Army of the Dead joining the fight. All Razor needs to do is just keep this rogue out in the open. Let the pests do work on him. Evasion coming out. It's going to vanish. And Cloaker Shadows burned every defensive out of that situation. And he decided to vanish out as soon as he saw Razor with their death pack. Still can get dots on the fast skills. If he can grip that rogue next to the Army of the Dead, they can still probably do quite a bit of damage. Is he going to do it exactly that? No, he's actually going to wait out. And fast skills actually just going to shadow step him into the belly of the beast where Razor and his abomination is going to faint away. Fastkill does get the safety trinket. It's going to be his last defensive left ever. Might just want to peel out of that situation. Astro's Fusion coming in for Razor. There's no way he's just going to be able to snag the health down. He's just stacking necrotics. Blind coming in. But Fastkill's with health completely dampened. Fed chasing and diseases rolling on him. Down he goes. And that's going to be the end of that. What the hell even happened? That was like a lot of back and forth. We didn't even see the Holy Pally play. Oh my god. I think it was Sparks team that didn't... Yeah, I think it was... Was it Sparks team?